Thanks for joining us on a brand new episode of 420 grams. 420 grams dot 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 coronavirus special. देखिए जी coronavirus हमारे show पे भी आ चुका है. इसीलिए आप जो देख रहे हैं ना, this is called social distancing between the 420 grams के जो तीन किरदार हैं, Mr. Jaydeep Basu, Siddhanth Aney and my name is Arjun. हम लोग तीन अलग अलग जगहों पे बैठ के, ताकि हम लोग close proximity में ना हो, हम लोग आपके लिए show ला रहे हैं. लेकिन सिद्धांत के साथ स्टूडियो में एटलीस्ट 5-6 टेक्नीशियन है, तो वहां कौन सी सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग चल रही है ये मुझे पता नहीं है. लेकिन 420 ग्राम के जो किरदार है उनके बीच में जो सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग चल रही है. सिद्धांत, जयदीप सर, थैंक्स सो मच फॉर जॉइनिंग अस गाइस. लेकिन ये तो ऑफ कोर्स थोड़ा हंसी मजाक चलता ही रहता है हमारे शो पे, बट वी विल स्टार्ट विद अ सीरियस टॉपिक. सीरियस टॉपिक कंसर्निंग एन इंडियन लेजेंड, मिस्टर पीके बैनर्जी. जयदीप सर, व्हाट्स द अपडेट ऑन हिज हेल्थ? वेयर डू थिंग्स स्टैंड करंटली?
आई थिंक वी शुडंट से इट, बट इन एज मेनी वर्ड्स इट इज लाइक It's quite a hopeless situation, I believe. Because अगर आप देखिए पिछले एक महीने से जो उनके मेडिकल अपडेट, उनके जो भी जिन्हें प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल has been admitted, they were issuing medical bulletins which looked quite hopeful. Sometimes they are checking, but yesterday the kind of medical bulletin they have issued, it seems they are now trying their last ditch, it seems. तो ऐसे तो देखिए, पीके बैनर्जी फ्रॉम 2007 ऑनवर्ड्स व्हेन ही हैड अ ब्रेन हेमरेज, 7 or 8 ऑनवर्ड्स ही वाज, मतलब हिज हेल्थ वाज डिटोरिएटिंग, बट समहाउ ही वाज मैनेजिंग. बट नाउ आई थिंक वी शुड बी प्रिपेयर फॉर द वर्स्ट.
So let's hope for the best though. Could you tell us, for the people who are of course watching the show, the timeline of sir's health and how it's deteriorated? आपने कहा 2007 was the brain hemorrhage and ever since then he's been battling bad health.
Yeah, 2007 or 8, I don't, not so. What happened? His movement got restricted. शुरू में ऐसा हुआ था, for the first few months he was talking very incoherently. He was not being able to communicate properly. But he having him, we should not say, he had very good health. From his young days, his health was quite strong. So he somehow managed to recover. Of course, there was some slur in his voice. It was difficult to say what he was saying. We managed to communicate with him, and slowly he looked he was on the recovery path, and he was taking interest in several things, on football. Actually, since I know him for a long time, he was very keenly watching the IPL matches, and he was very impressed with the physical fitness of the IPL boys. He always liked the way their physical fitness was. But in last May, when I met him in Calcutta, I went over to Calcutta and I made it a point that I should meet him. That time, what shocked me first, that he failed to recognize me, which was a shock to me because we know each other for 40 years. So I was a bit disappointed. Then he recognized me, but the way he was talking, I could guess he was not always following me, or we are not being able to follow him, or whatever it is. In between, he had been to hospital a few times, and he returned home. He recovered, he returned home. But this time, it seems that things are slowly deteriorating.
I wanted to ask you, that 83 years, he's led, and more than half of his life, you've known him, Jaydeep. So, so much history, so many stories. Anything that comes to your mind that sort of highlights the sort of person that PK Banerjee is?
PK Banerjee, I have not seen him as a footballer. I was not born, or I was too young when he left football to watch football. I saw him only as a coach, and only heard about his stories. Lots of things comes to my mind. PK Banerjee's, one thing that comes to my mind was his dedication to the game. I'm talking about 1999 SAF football in Goa. Sukhvinder Singh was India coach, and PK Banerjee was the technical director. and of the team. India was a crack side, one of the finest side in many years. I.M. Vijayan, Joe Palancheri, Baichung Bhutia, Bruno Coutinho. It was a very, very good India side. And I remember in the middle of the tournament, I went to his room and he looked a bit crestfallen. So I said, what happened? He says, I got a call from Calcutta today. It says that my daughter is not too well. I said, so what exactly happened? He says, even doctors don't know, but they have asked her to be checked in Bombay's Tata Memorial, which itself was quite a shocking news. The moment we know it, you know how anyone feels.
Mm.
So I said, there was still 3 days. It was, I think, 3 days, 2 days before the final, if I remember. India were playing Bangladesh in the final. So I said, so Pradeepda, you are going tonight or you will go tomorrow? He says, how can I go before the final is played? Because I'm being entrusted with a job and I must finish it. And I remember Sukhiji, the coach, also said, Dada, if you want, you can go. He says, no, let's wait. So he kept on the phone. On the phone, he was with his family.
So as a player, I was saying that, of course, none of us were around when India won that Asian Games gold and all of that. But even as a coach, he influenced multiple generations of footballers in this country. And some of, like you said, sort of oversaw, nurtured or whatever, coached who are known as some of the most talented footballers to come out of India. All these guys, Baichung, Bruno, all the people you're talking about, Joe Paul, they've all played at clubs and things that, or in the national setup where he's overlooked that. So what kind of a coach was he? I mean, a dedication to the game at a personal level, that passion and all of that, undoubtedly. But what sort of a coach was he, and how did he sort of relate to the players who were under his care?
Now, if you ask me that, I would say his best coaching days were between 1970 and 1986. After 1986, he remained a coach. But to talk about it dispassionately, we didn't see anything new from him.
Right.
He was using what he learned earlier. After 1967, when he retired from football, he went to the Detmar Kramer coaching camp. That was the first batch of Indian going for a FIFA coaching course. Detmar Kramer was a huge coach. He was a German coach. He was responsible for changing Japan football. So he went there and came back. And I think what he learned at that time, for the next 10 years, between 1970 and 1980, he produced wonders. If you look at it, in 1970, when he was not given the charge alone. The Ghulam Mohammad Basha of Bangalore was also jointly with him. He handled the Indian team with Mr. Basha, of course. It was not his, he was not alone. You look at the records, 1969 Merdeka, India won the third place. 1970 Asian Games, India won the bronze medal. Actually, 1970 Asian Games, I think Stanley Rouse was the FIFA president at that time. Mm. He was present in the tournament and he says India is the best team in the tournament. It's a pity that India lost in the semifinals to Burma, now Myanmar. So those were his golden days. I think from if you look at this list of players he produced, but he nurtured, because he was always a coach of a big club. So big clubs don't produce players.
Right.
But he nurtured from Subhash Bhoumik, Sudhir Karmakar, Muhammad Habib, Muhammad Akbar, Shyam Thapa, Subrata Bhattacharya. I can say lots of names who all played for India at that time were under his coaching. Mm. So I think his best days in coaching his best days in coaching was between 1970 and 1982. After that, I would not like to say at this juncture, but I have to say that he only repeated himself.
Sir, I it's nice to since you're here and you interacted with him so much. My personal opinion is this: ki, you know, hamlog Bhaichung Bhutia, I am Vijayan, Joe Paul Ancheri, ab Sunil Chhetri ho gaya yahan pe. So we consider these guys to be the big players, the big marquee players of Indian football along our history. But if I had to compare them with that batch of the 60s and the 70 Asian Games, jo aapne abhi baat kari, ye unke aas paas bhi nahi hote, sir. Mere hisab se. हालांकि मैंने उनको खेलते हुए कभी देखा नहीं है बट जस्ट गोइंग बाय व्हाट दे हैव डन ऑन द फील्ड एट दैट टाइम और अगर आप कह रहे हो कि भाईचुंग आई एम एंड नाउ ऑफ कोर्स सुनील हैड अ सर्टेन अमाउंट ऑफ फैसिलिटीज अ सर्टेन अमाउंट ऑफ कोचिंग एक्सीलेंस नॉलेज उस टाइम पे तो कुछ भी नहीं होगा दैट्स व्हाई इट्स कॉल्ड द गोल्डन जनरेशन ऑफ इंडियन फुटबॉल सो फॉर ऑल दीस किड्स हु ऑफ कोर्स लुक अप टू भाईचुंग टू आई एम विजयन टू जो पॉल एंचरी There was a PK Banerjee before that. There was a late Mr. Chunni Goswami before that, who for me, at least in my personal opinion, is way ahead of where these boys are currently right now.
Arjun, you are absolutely right. But football has, first of all, football is different those days. Football is different these days. Okay, I accept it. At the same time, the team which won the 62 Asian Games gold medal, see, it's not that there was no tactical thing in it. First of all, Mr. Rahim, who was the great coach, he started this team from 1956. He slowly assembled the team. 56 Olympics, we reached fourth. 58 Asian Games, we reached semifinals. 60 Rome Olympics, we played very, very, we qualified for the Olympics and played very creditably against teams like France and Hungary and Peru. We did not qualify for the second round, but we played so well. So he was building up and he's perhaps the, Rahim was perhaps the greatest tactician India has ever produced on football field. So he slowly built up this team and his final bow was the actually the 62 Asian Games. If you look at the 62 Asian Games team, the average age of the 62 Asian Games team was 27. The average height of 62 Asian Games team was 5'10 or 5'11. It is never in history India has got a team like that. Everybody is fit at the peak of their career and height-wise on the field, they were most of them were tall boys. And of course, they were exceptionally skillful. So it's that not that the 62 thing came up in one day. It took a lot of time. And if you look at it in 63, Mr. Rahim passed away. He had cancer of the lungs. He had lung. He was a heavy smoker. So he suffered from lung cancer and passed away in 1963. He was not even 60 at that time. And slowly, and Harry Wright, the British coach, was brought in as his replacement. Slowly, Indian football going. So there was huge planning behind it. Mm. Of course, nowadays planning is different. Those days planning is different. What different? Nowadays you have 20 support staff with the team. There is a nutritionist, there is a physical conditioner, there are so many things. Those days it was not there because it was not there. That's all.
So I think मोटी मोटी कहानी तो ये है जैसे आप क्रिकेट में बात करते हो ना 1983 में when you won that World Cup that proved to be the catalyst for India as a cricketing nation and they've gone from strength to strength from there they might have sort of you know somewhat in the middle बीच में गाड़ी कहीं अटकी होगी but they've always gone up at a slow pace at a fast pace whatever it be for India that catalyst came in the 1960s the 1962 जैसे आप कह रहे हैं 56 से टीम बन रही थी जाके फल जो उन्होंने actually खाया है 62 में खाया है From there on, you should have been growing, growing and growing. And even Novi Kabadia sir, said the same thing. He said that should have been the catalyst for Indian football. But despite of us or rather staying at the same place or going up at a snail's pace, we kept going down, down and down, which is why we are where we are right now in Indian football. And all the other nations then, of course, caught up at such a fast pace and kept on moving ahead from us.
Yeah, I mean, the trajectories of the nations have also been different. It's one of the major things, you have events that are catalysts. But then, there has to be an overall environment which allows that to happen. Like, television in 83, 20 years after this Asian Games gold medal, right? Mm. The situation with mass media was very different from... And actually, some of these revolutions were aided, not it was... of course, winning the World Cup was massive, but the fact that that World Cup was being watched on TV by so many people, and then as the years progressed, that television technology improved, live broadcasting became more frequent. So these things happened simultaneously, na?
See,
the reason why we talk about like Bhaichung and IM and all of these guys as great players that we remember with nostalgia and whatever, one is of course because that's when we grew up watching the sport and those were the idols of the time, but the other is also because we could actually watch them even though we were not at the stadium, which was not necessarily the case for previous generations. तो
फेयर एंड भाई, बट मैं कह रहा हूं हर जमाने का अपना तरीका होता है, जनता तक पहुंचने का तरीका होता है. मैं कह रहा हूं मतलब 62 में आपके पास टीवी नहीं है तो क्या हो गया. पॉइंट इज 62 56 से अगर आपकी टीम बन रही है, 62 में आपने अगर आके जाके देखा है कि देखो जी हमारे जो लड़के हैं दे कैन प्ले अमंगस्ट द बेस्ट इन द कॉन्टिनेंट, देन दैट शुड हैव बीन यूज्ड एट व्हाटएवर वे पॉसिबल टू कीप ऑन ग्रोइंग इट. बट द इंडियन एज अ नेशन वी फेल्ड ओवर देयर ना फुटबॉल में, कि हम नीचे ही नीचे आते गए.
Actually, Arjun, we missed the bus. If you look at the, as what you said is absolutely right. If you look at the progress, 62 Asian Games, we won the gold medal. 66, we couldn't do much. 70, we again won the Asian Games bronze medal. Means we reached up to semi-final and won the third place, which was not bad. And 74 Asian Championship, we were champions. We drew 2-2 with Iran in the final. Shabir Ali's team went. But what happened? We completely missed the bus. We failed to notice the fact that football in the continent is changing. There were which Japan realized, which Korea realized, which lost of most of the West Asian this country's Gulf countries realized, but we did not realize. We missed the bus in the 70s. We thought we are comfortable in our amateur setup. So since result is, but the continent is changing. Had we caught up with them, I am not saying we would have been like Korea or Japan, but we could have been like Oman. We could have been like Iraq. We could have been like Iran. Iran is, of course, they have been a best, one of the finest football playing countries in Asia for a long, long time. Not today, for 60, 70 years. That's a different. But we could have been at least come anywhere near them. But players had given us the direction, at least by playing, that where we can reach. And the domestic football was full of spectators. Every day there used to be 20,000-25,000 people for domestic matches. But we could cash them. We should have cashed them, which cricket did after 83. They cashed them. So in what way appreciate what the cricket officials did, but our football officials couldn't.
Sir, just one final question on PK, sir. Because you know Calcutta is a crazy city. I love the city and the people in the city and their love for arts and sports and so on, and especially football. Give us a Calcutta and PK Banerjee tale, sir. Itne wahan pe kahaniyan chalti hain, kuch to ek kahani bataiye aap.
PK Banerjee ka kahani to matlab there are hundreds of kahani. First of all, PK Banerjee, as a footballer, he never played for a big team. He always played for Eastern Railway. Eastern Railway is, however, of course, he was a great player, but in domestic football, Eastern Railway was no match to Mohun Bagan or East Bengal. But Pradeep Das' biggest thing was his ability to interact with the fans. He will in those days in 70s, I remember when they will say in a local match, if the team is not scoring, maybe he's coaching East Bengal at that time. The team is not scoring. By halftime, there will be a lot of choices, invectives from the member gallery. People will start abusing, and most of the time, what happens? The officials try to run away or try to somehow manage evade, but Mr. Banerjee will go and start arguing with them. There were used to be so many photographs that from one side of the fence, he's arguing with the supporters. And then he'll say, give us time, give us 20 more minutes, I will see what to be done. And he was not afraid to be supported by surrounded by supporters, by fans, by angry fans. He was there to face it. So, see, lots of things looked from sitting now. We think sometimes it sounds very funny or looks funny. But overall, he was an interactive coach. He was not. He was a kind of man who was never away from the general public, general fans. He understood their importance on the ground. He is not that you have to go through the PR agency to get a few quotes from him.
Yeah.
What we face very regularly these days.
I wish that could change nowadays.
Yeah, he was there, always there to face it.
Yeah.
So he has, see, in 1982, I remember an incident, since Arjun is asking, his other side of his character. In 1982 against India in Delhi, he was the coach. India lost in the quarterfinals. It was a heartbreaking defeat for India. I think India was playing Saudi Arabia in the quarterfinal. Last minutes, 89th minute, India conceded the goal. And that was the end of it, of going to the semifinals. So next, he was very upset. And next day, I think he made a comment somewhere, said he blamed his players, which he did. He had reason to blame because defenders were not doing well. He says, if you have kadi ka masala, usse biryani nahi ban sakta hai. So one journalist I remember wrote that, yeah, Mr. Banerjee is right, that kadi ka masala se to biryani nahi ban sakta hai. Lekin we are yet to get any proof that Mr. Banerjee is capable of cooking biryani.
So how this is still relevant in the context of Indian football even today, because if you are qualifying for the 2026 World Cup, then you have to make biryani.
Biryani,
nahi,
sir. Biryani pack.
You have to
deliver. You have to buy it.
लेकिन हमारे पास मसाला तो अभी भी कड़ी का ही है.
The gentleman happened to be my editor at that time. So when I met him, he says, I am not going to talk to you. Your editor is a friend of mine for 20 years and he has insulted me so badly on this thing. But after 2 days, I found him. He's having tea with the same man. I said, you said you don't want to talk to him. He says, okay, past is past. Why bother? Whatever happened is. So that way he was a very pragmatic person. I am not saying that he never committed mistakes. I can list at least 50 things which he shouldn't have done in Indian football. But in all together as a package, if you are look at it, he is the most sellable product of Indian football. A man like him is needed in the game always.
So then we wish him a speedy recovery and we hope his health does take a turn for the better. And of course, this was some great anecdotes there by sir. Halanki yahan pe humne baat kari ki unhone press se yahan pe baat kari hai. Kuch hi din pehle hamare jo president hai, unhone bhi kuch press ke chuninda logon ko bulaya ghar pe ek interview dene ke liye. Aaj main ek aur padh raha tha. Hindustan Times mein ek interview aaya hai dost. Usme aapne 2226 ki yahan pe baat kari hai World Cup ki aap kaise bol sakte ho ki 2226 mein. उन्होंने उसको क्लैरिफाई किया है. उन्होंने कहा 2226 एम करने में क्या जा रहा है भाई, एम क्यों नहीं करना चाहिए 2226 के लिए, तब तो आपकी 48 टीमें. तो वो कह रहे एम हो रहा है, वो ये नहीं कह रहे कि मतलब मैं पहुंचने वाला हूं वहां पे, पर वो कह रहे मैं एम कर रहा हूं.
अच्छा,
तो फेयर एनफ. मैंने आपको पिछले दिन बताया था कि मैं 6th क्लास को पास नहीं हुआ, मैं 12th क्लास की एम कर रहा हूं बैठ के.
पर सर, जब से ISL आया है तो आपके 6th से आप 10th पे पहुंच गए हो ना. कहीं ना कहीं आपके बीच में आपके सोच चल रही है कि सडनली इतना इन्फ्लक्स ऑफ कैश आ गया, इतना इन्फ्लक्स ऑफ फॉरेन टैलेंट आ गया और फॉरेन थिंकिंग आ गया कि आपको लग रहा है कि जो आपने वो 4 साल जो आपने जंप किए हैं, कहीं ना कहीं आप वो अपने क्वालिफिकेशन प्रोसेस में भी जंप कर सकते हो. एटलीस्ट उनका नजरिया ये हो सकता है.
बिहार यूपी में फेक सर्टिफिकेट्स बहुत मिलता है आजकल, आप मिल सकते हैं 10 के लिए.
No, so we this is what we're talking about. Now, before the influx of a lot of this, whether it's investment or whatever, television or all of that, was when it was in India's peak in this sport. Yeah. Since then, जो भी आप जैसे भी आप curve बना लें, कोई upward trajectory तो दिखाई नहीं दे रहा है ना खास. सिर्फ एक चीज है कि money is being invested, and therefore a lot of different people are asking for returns on that investment. ये तो है, लेकिन वो मतलब आप कड़ी को बिरयानी के पैकेजिंग में बना के दे रहे हैं या ऐसा ही कुछ. मे बी दिस एनालॉजी हैज बीन टेकन टू फार.
मुझे भूख लग गई है वैसे.
सो
only optimistic thing is that optimism is that there a lot of money has come, as Siddhant has said, and we only hope for one more thing: the money is being used properly.
Privatization leading to efficiency is a very long conversation which we can have.
No, but it's in their interest that the league does well, right?
Haan, but it's in their
interest.
Now, of course, it's in their interest, but that doesn't mean that.
As well, it has some effect on the national team.
Just because it's in your interest to make more profit doesn't mean you're the best equipped person to actually achieve that end result, even if that is the end result.
No, and I'm not saying that. I'm just saying if someone is putting their money, whatever amount of money, whatever their this thing might be, it is in their interest that the league does well. And if the league does well, somewhere or the other, you can see a knock-on effect taking into the players who are playing for your national team. Because eventually, hum log teeno yahan pe kya baat kar rahe hain? Hum nahi baat kar rahe ki ISL is such a wonderful league, it's so great that I'm a fan of it. Theek hai, nahi baat kar rahe. Hum log har din jab baat karte hain, to hum log national team ki baat karte hain. So kahin na kahin knock-on effect national team mein aa raha hai ki nahi? Ye hai ji sawal.
हाँ वो तो ऐसे which Mr. Patel says maybe in 5-6 years it will come, which is of course okay. We agree on that also. Let us agree on that also. But the thing is that in that thing what एक simple point है कि आपको थोड़ा number of Indian players बढ़ाना पड़ेगा. Our pool of players have become too small. जैसे अर्जुन उस दिन बोल रहे थे 45 आदमी को बुलाया कैंप में, बच्चा कौन है? तो वो ही
लेनी रोली है.
He answered the question also. Very good. No, so
Skype is gone.
No, he's back.
So aadmi kaun hai? Matlab aapko your pool of players, yaar 45 player to aapko Luxembourg mein bhi mil jayega mere khayal se. Isn't it? Even I think Luxembourg has a bigger pool of players. That is the problem. So वो पहले first of all which team had said, and he what he said is very urgent. He said कि number of foreigners has to bring down. Where do I get players? Do I play a player as a forward who has never played as a forward in domestic football? It's a very valid question. And if you look at it, Arjun and Siddha, you look at it, he has not been replied.
So even Stephen Constantine. Whenever he said, जब मैं कैंप लगाता था तो मैं पूछता था कौन है लड़के जो सेंटर में खेलेंगे, किसी का हाथ ऊपर उठता ही नहीं था. Then he says, अच्छा कौन है लड़के जो वाइड राइट वाइड लेफ्ट पे खेलेंगे, पूरे कैंप का हाथ उठ जाता था. Because majority of them are playing in that position in their clubs. अब इसमें ISL की गलती नहीं है सर, आई लीग वाले भी यही गलती करते थे रेगुलरली, टू बी फेयर. क्योंकि जब आई लीग होता था तब भी हम कहते थे कि क्या है सारे फॉरनर्स आपके स्पाइन बन जाते हैं और जो बाहर के जो आपका सपोर्टिंग एक्ट है वो आपके इंडियन प्लेयर्स बन जाते
हैं. या अग्रीड, बट द डिफरेंस वाज दैट द नंबर्स वर स्टिल कंटेन्ड ना. तो वन वे ऑर द अदर आपको खिलाने ही पड़ते हैं इंडियन प्लेयर्स. छह नहीं थे ना आपके पास खिलाने के लिए या जो भी है. तो
दैट सिंपल सॉल्यूशन, फॉलो द एएफसी रूल ऑफ 1 3+1.
सी दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम. आई थिंक वी ऑलवेज वांट टू बी द एक्सेप्शन. रूल जो बना है रूल, तो जैसे मिस्टर पटेल आल्सो सेइंग एट एवरी प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस ही सेज दैट फीफा हैज बीन वेरी सपोर्टेड टू इंडिया एंड दिस एंड दैट, बिकॉज यू नो एंड ऑफ द डे इफ द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया कम्स एंड सेज यार बच्चों का टूर्नामेंट हो रहा है, एज इन लाइक अंडर 17 टूर्नामेंट इज हैपनिंग, वी नीड समवन टू होस्ट इट, हाउ मेनी कंट्रीज आर इक्विप्ड टू होस्ट इट एंड हैव द काइंड ऑफ गवर्नमेंट दैट्स विलिंग टू स्पेंड टैक्स पेयर्स मनी टू होस्ट दीज काइंड ऑफ बिग टूर्नामेंट्स. So, of course, FIFA will be nice to you. But at some point, they'll also say, yeah, bus, now you need to kind of do things yourself. Like, for example, we had when Isaac Doru was in the other day, and he was talking about, he was just talking about how FIFA is not even continuing to support certain programs. But they had, for example, a development officer who was posted in some state associations to help the state associations kind of get their act together, get a little professionalized and all that. So, wo bhi paisa band hone wala hai. So, matlab, ye endlessly nahi chalta rahega, I think.
भाई ये जो कॉन्वर्सेशन है हमारी इन सर्कल
राउंड या इट इज गोइंग राउंड एंड राउंड एंड आई थिंक इट्स आल्सो
आगे चलाने नहीं आगे चलाने का एक नजरिया बताऊं अगर आईएसएल वाले हमारा शो देखेंगे ना पहले तो ऐसे करेंगे ब्लैकलिस्ट तीनों ब्लैकलिस्ट और उसके बाद नहीं होने वाला चेंज फॉर्मेट चेंज होगा 10 साल के बाद ही होगा जो भी होगा उससे पहले कुछ नहीं
The question is very simple. I have only one question to ask. You want to glorify your product or you want to glorify the national team?
Currently, sir, it's the product.
And so then coming back to your point on like private entities and private capital coming to the rescue, that's the thing now, because at the end of the day, you're looking to glorify or grow or whatever your product. You're not really, if anything happens, if there is a, like you said, a knock-on effect to the national team, it's a knock-on effect. It's not the primary objective from which the league is or the structure of the sport is being created. That's exactly why we need to have, of course, the way things are, private capital is what it is. But that's why public officials, people and sport has to have some sort of public governance which is accountable and who's looking at it from the perspective of growing the sport, not just... a league or a product or a club or whatever. Because फिर तो सबका agenda अलग अलग हो जाता है ना
उस level पे. I think Siddhant, my only optimism is that I have been told that they are now realizing that if they start improving the national team, its effect will automatically improve the other products.
Yeah, 100%. 100%.
So I believe they are being told by people that this should be done, and they are slowly realizing it. If that happens, then nothing like it. Then it is right. Again, we will go on the proper direction at this we have.
ठीक है सर, I think we'll wrap up this conversation here. Once again, wishing PK Banerjee, a legend of Indian football, well, or at least that he goes in peace, and our thoughts with his family, of course, and all the fans and everyone whose lives he's touched through the course of his, I mean, I guess a lifetime in football.
I would like to add one line, Siddhant Arjun, in it, that Mr. Banerjee is the only person who is living at the moment who has scored winning goals in a gold medal match for India. Mewalal in 1951 Asian Games is no more with us. Mm-hmm. India beat South Korea 2-1 in the 62 final. Janel Singh scored the other goal. Janel Saab has also passed away. Now, Pradipda was the only person who has scored a gold medal goal in a final for India.
The last of that golden generation, basically.
We hope he lives for many, many years with us.
Thank you so much. We'll be back. It is a time of social distancing and we'll be coming to you with updates on what's happening in the sporting world and other conversations. Just got a message from the Indian Olympic Association saying that the Sports Authority of India has cancelled or put on hold, suspended all national camps across age groups, all Sports Authority of India training centres. Their athletes will be sent home and stuff like that. So I guess we urge you all to also keep your distance, stay safe, but also look after each other.
One last thing. The next episode should be on basically ab jo ye quarantine ho gaya hai na, of all the teams. And sab player apne ghar var chale gaye hain. Aur kisi ko kuch pata nahi hai ki camp kab shuru hone wala hai.
Yeah.
To is dauran pe, jo player apne aap ko har din kuch na kuch karte rehta hai, fit rakhne ke liye, player ko kya karna chahiye ya kya kar sakta hai. And it'll be better if you can get some of these players on Skype, man.
Yeah, and also so many of the other guys, some of the coaches and the other experts who we bring on to maybe so we can put out some stuff that will help not just elite level players, but also regular people like us who play amateur football and are also stuck at home and would like
elite amateur players.
Yeah. All right. Thank you, Jaydeep, Pandit. Thanks for joining, guys. Thanks for watching. Catch us on NewsClick, YouTube, Facebook.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.